So I appreciate you answering that question. So let me go ahead and flip it. So when I say what's your wall, a couple of words that I heard was builder. So if you was to look at your genealogy and take it all the way back, when you look at Richie and break down the essence of what that means and look at the actual meaning of it and go back down the generations, you would probably find quite a few builders in your family that's passed that down. Also, as a not just an African-American male, but also whether Jamaican, whether Haitian, whether all these other cultures that comprise of who you are, and not just a one-dimensional individual, however people want to see you as. When I understand your walk, when you share with me your culture and the essence of who you are, I have the motive and I have the willingness to assist you to be the best person that you are. Until I get to that point, we really haven't had a chance to really make that heart-to-heart, that soul connection. We really haven't had a chance to build. Mm-hmm. It takes a community to build it. You know, they say that individuals can go to school and they only learn 14% of what they need in school. But 86% of what they learn and what they get is from the different people, from the mentors, from the parents, from the aunts, from the uncles. They get that other information from the community. And it's by that same thing. It's by understanding the different people's walks, respecting that, and then trying to aid it and sharpen each other.
Not to be contrary, right? But I want to kind of test it a little bit. So you were talking about what the community projects is a huge percentage of what a person learns, right? So from my perspective, we have a lot of healing to do, a lot of rehabilitation to do, right? In the meantime, we have projects, trailer parks, ghettos, I mean, you name it, like so many places where people have been systematically tossed aside, right, ignored, undereducated, underloved, and in fact, beaten down lots of ways, right? To the point where a lot of those communities beat each other down,
right?
So if 80%+ of what you learn is from a community that has been abused and continues the cycles of violence, then what do you do with that? Like, how do you rehabilitate that kind of trauma?
And that's a deep question. And that actually goes straight to the core of it, because we are a community right now that's groping for answers, you know, on all sides. If you talk to the leadership, the clerics, if you talk to the pastors, the preachers, if you talk to, you know, NAACP, everybody's looking for answers all the way up to the White House. Not only the economy, but how do we do this? How do we create jobs? How do we get people? You know, right now, 30% of the teenagers can't find jobs. And they're expecting the teenagers not to want money when everything you look at is on TV and it's there. It's really a paradigm shift. It really starts at the family unit. What you do as an individual in your family, by you, first of all, getting yourself to a place where you understand yourself, you understand your walk, you have a certain level of dedication to your legacy, and you start to create those things. And then when I said the expand, if your family's doing bad, like Abraham Maslow, the hierarchy of needs, if you ain't got food, shelter, and clothing, man, it's gonna be very difficult to go out and help anybody else. And so there is a community effort to take care of those basics. And when there's members in the community that don't have those basics, it's really tough. It starts with an individual. It's like that movie, Pay It Forward. It started with one individual who actually believed and had the same hope, had the dream, didn't let his dream go away, and started making those efforts. So with just one family, and we've seen many examples, you know, one such example is that, you know, based on my faith background, there's been individuals who have went to areas that were destitute, that they had community life, and they had the things that they needed to have community, but they didn't have anything that could elevate them to that point to understand what it means to be noble. especially after they've been told based on certain aspects that they're born sinners, or certain aspects that they can't achieve. And so one of the things that I've seen is the Word of God, and a lot of people, you know, a lot of people don't like to hear religion, they don't like to hear spirituality. But man, when you're a spiritual being, and when we are as individuals aren't seen as souls, it's very difficult. You know, I got one soul right here. That's the name of my rap group with me and my wife. And we chose that name because it's the goal of all of us as humanity, is to be one soul. It's hard for me and my wife to agree all the time. So if it's hard for us, I know it's hard for all of us, but it's a goal. And so going back to that example, to go into an area where you basically pack up, you pioneer, you go to an area to assist them, to give them the access to the source, to the Word of God, and to enable them to create a walk. You enable them to see the end destination, and then to turn right back around and say, use this for myself, for my family, and then started to spread it. There's never a way that we would be putting on earth, which I consider a training ground. And it really is a training ground to elevate and to assist us to know who we are as souls. But we would not be put in here without the proper guidance. That's like with our kids. How are we gonna chastise our kids if we didn't give them the proper counsel? It's not possible. And some parents do it. Some parents say, do as I say, but not as I do. When we look at it justly, it's making sure that they have that proper guidance, and we have that. But you have to look for it, man. And so what I share with this in a practical way is just a way to look at individuals. It might be difficult. You might still have problems. It might not be reciprocated. But if you can get a chance, you can only bond and help that individual when you really care about their walk at their pace, at their time. Not trying to convert, not trying to change them, not trying to elevate them, not trying to coerce them, not trying to do power, use greed. Because all those things that you shared when you talked about the different aspects of the community is abuse. It's abuse of different forms of power. And that's old school. It's really time for something else. And it's linked up to the source. And the source is many different lamps, but that light that's inside each of those lamps is the same. And it's the essence, which is really is the Word of God, which connects us to God, but also to His promise, which is the covenant. So there's many different ways, but in essence, it comes down to the nut, to, you know, when you crack it open, it's still that sustenance for the earth, man.
Beautiful. Well, fam, look forward to hearing comments on what the discussion generated. Please bring your concrete examples. Please bring your thoughts and your ideas. And I'd like to hear people talk through some of the things that they struggle with, because honestly, we all got things to learn from and we learn from each other best. So definitely hope that you are able to engage. This has been a really amazing experience with me talking to my homeboy, and hope you enjoyed it too. Thanks for joining us. Much love.